Good morning, I am Professor Ariel Vera, registered criminologist 96 and Master of Science in Criminology 2013, being a faculty member of PCR from year 2000-2008, and other school, I'm teaching fundamental partnership NCRY, and also I'm a corps of professor at the Police National Training Institute National Capital Region Training Center with the rank of Associate Professor 1. I am also accredited of Fire Explosive Office as official gun safety instructor, range safety officers. Actually, marami kami. Pero sa Criminology Academy, kakaunti lang. Now, I'm here to share about the most basic in gun safety handling. So every shooter must know this, every criminal student must know this, every PMP, every AFP, or even NBI, or any other which hold firearms, and even security guards should know this by heart, because this is the base of the gun safety handling, so called the four general rules of gun safety. So number one, we have the so-called treat all gun loaded even if you know it is unloaded. So if you saw a firearm either at the table or at a sofa, you all treat the guns as loaded. Even you saw it unloaded by someone. So for example, I wear a caliber 45. So basing from the outside, hindi mo talaga makikita eh. Wala ka namang x-ray vision. Di ba? So any other firearms, any other caliber, you treat the firearms loaded. So sa Tagalog, ibig sabihin, lahat ng makikita mong firearms, kailangan isipin mo na yan ay may laman o wala. Bakit? Because accident do not happen. It is cause. Sometimes, nang maling akala, ay akala ko walang bale. So, first, you need to check the chamber. No? So, you need to open it. So, tingnan mo, mayroon bang naka-insert na ammunition o wala. Makikita mo naman, mayroon bang brass. Silipin mo. So, wala. O, isa pa ulit. Silipin mo ulit. Wala. Isa pa ulit. Silipin mo ulit. Wala. And then you squeeze the trigger. That is only the time that we are going to declare that firearm is safe. So, yung iba ay masugrado. So, ganito. No? Okay rin naman. So, very clear na wala talagang brass sa loob. So, that is in compliance with the rule number one. Treat all guns loaded even if it is unloaded. So, mga security guards, karami naman sa inyo ay caliber 38. So, makikita mo agad kung mayroong bullets doon o wala. Sa mga pistol type, you need to maneuver the chamber so that you can personally see whether it is empty or not. So, you do not believe someone. Okay na yan, tanggalan ko na ng bala yan. Ang nangyari is, natanggalan niya lang ng magazine. Pero mayroong pala nakapid sa chamber. Then, accident can occur. Alright? So, we go to rule number two. Be sure of your target and what lies behind it. So, for example, you aim your firearms, for example, in the range, no? So, sa target range, whether indoor or outdoor, meron silang mga tao-tao dyan eh, yung naglalagay ng mga target board, yung mga nagsaset up. Pagka ang mga yan eh, pumunta dun sa dulo, no? sa target base. You do not conduct any aiming of your firearms because the target range is not clear. So, pag sinabi natin na the range is clear, means say, range clear, clear from your eyesight na walang ibang individual o tao na matatamaan doon. Alright, so, be sure of your target. The target is the target board or the metals and what lies behind it. Usually, lahat naman ng indoor or outdoor range ay meron silang safety, no? Meron tech wall doon. So again, kung pag-usapan natin ay range, pagka yung mga tauhan ng range ay nandun sa target base, you do not perform even a scenario based sa aiming because accident occur, no? It is post and it is harmful to any individual present therein. Alright? So, the next rule is, by the way, you do not forget the so-called muzzle down, no? So, if this is the firearm, ito yung muzzle, dito nangyari yung muzzle blast, yung umaapoy na nakita sa dilim. So, ito yung muzzle point. Always muzzle down. Alright, always muzzle down. Especially when you are just a beginner. Alright, always muzzle down. Pag yung, marunong na ako, so lagi naka point black dun sa target. No. Pag tapos ko na pumutok, muzzle down. Alright. And then we go to the third, the trigger finger up. So, nung pinopoint ko yung muscle, marina po ninyo aking trigger, no? Ito yung trigger guard, ito yung aking trigger finger. Finger that will squeeze the trigger. So, kung ano man ang gagawin mo, always trigger finger out, mag-release ka ng magazine, mag-chamber ka, trigger finger out. Hindi yun nakaganyan. Lalo na kung naka-chamber pin. So, sino mga usually, hindi naman sort of violator, pero yung mga nakakalimot. Yung mga bumili ng mga firearms, mga responsible gun owner, bumili sila for family protection. Kaya lang, hindi sila masyadong nadaan sa poros of gun safety. So, dun sa bahay nila, lagi nakatrigger yan. Nandun na sa squeeze na. Lagi squeeze na rin. So, dyan minsan nangyari may mga natama na anak, asawa, katulong, and so on and so forth. So, kung mayroon kang firearms, nakapag-aral ka, okay yun. Professional ka, okay yun. Pero, kailangan mo dumaan sa four rules of gun safety. Eh sir, di ba meron naman kami doon sa LTAP pag kukuha kami ng LTAP license? Eh, no comment about that. Pero, itong video na ito ay supplement. Baka nakalimutan mo lang. Alright? So, always trigger finger out. Alright? Always trigger finger out. So, muzzle down, trigger finger out. Alright? So, do not forget that. And then, the fourth and the last is the decide your target. So, you do not aim your weapons or firearms to anybody you do not intend to shoot. Ay, nabaril ko eh, pero hindi ko naman sinasad yung baril yun. Kasi hindi ka nga umatin sa gantong gun safety seminars, even in online. So, nandun ko sa indoor target range, andito yung kaibigan mo. Bro, papicture na tayo, nakatutok na sa kanya. So, pumutok. Is that your target? Is your friend your target? No. Pero ba't pumutok? Kasi hindi mo hindi mo alam o nakalimutan mo na only point your firearm to the target you intend to shoot. Diba? So, okay lang yung mag-selfie kayo ng barkada mo, pero muscle down. Di muscle fronting the target board or the metal target. Di mag-selfie kayo. Alright? Dito maraming nangyayari aksidente kahit nasa outdoor. No? So, one of our responsibilities if you are an owner or you have a firearm issued to you by the government is the safety handling of firearms for yourself, for your family, and for the rest of all other persons beyond the perimeter of the firearms. Next, we have the combat shooting. That will be another topic. Thank you.